Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming and joining me on the Feed My Sheep Foundation for another Bible study. We are studying Psalm 68 on this video, and it's a psalm written by David just about praise and worship to the Almighty Heavenly Father. And I can tell you from many days and times of experience how praise and worship just pulls you and places you in the presence of the Almighty God. And I'm telling you, what a place to be in the mighty name of Christ, you know. So we're going to go ahead and start with Psalm 68. He says, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. Okay? If, you know, hating God, let them be gone. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melts before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. Hallelujah. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yes, let them exceedingly rejoice. Now, again, this is a psalm David is saying, and an admonition toward God, and praise toward God, and worship toward God, and reverence toward God, and acknowledging him as the holy, 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 heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Christ, hallelujah. Verse 4 says, sing unto God. Sing praises to his name. Extol him that rides upon the heavens. So by his name, Jah, and rejoice before him. A father of the fatherless and a judge of the widows is God in his holy habitation. So that is who our God is. He is a father of the fatherless and a judge of the widows. Verse 6 says, God sets the solitary in families. He brings out those which are bound with chains. But the rebellious dwell in a dry land, okay? The rebellious dwells in a dry land, he says, because they have distanced themselves from God. They won't make it to a promised land because they have not. They have decided not to go in the way of the Lord, in the way of heaven's destiny. So therefore, that's what placed them into a dry land. So, O God, when thou went forth before thy people, when thou did march through the wilderness, the earth shook, the heavens also dropped at the presence of God. Even Sinai itself was moved at the presence of God, the God of Israel. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your mighty presence. And let it continue to move and shake and make things possible and happen in the earth, as it always has, for you, because you have decreed and declared in your word all things are possible with you, through you, and because of you. So because of your Holy Spirit, your anointing, anything can be possible. And we ask that you do it. Do it mightily on the earth in the mighty name of Christ. Hallelujah. And then he goes on to say, thou, O God, did send a plentiful rain, whereby thou didst confirm thine inheritance when it was weary, and thy congregation has dwelt therein. For thou, O God, hast prepared of thy goodness for the poor. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those that published it. Okay, so now he's talking about how good God is in sending his word and making sure his word is manifested in the earth and published throughout all, for all to see it and made available for all of us to know about him and to know who he is and of his goodness and how we became into existence and, you know, how we were created. He published that and he made that possible. Verse 12 said, kings of armies did flee apace, and she that tarried, let's get that off. Okay, where did that stop me? I had got a little confused, a little interruption by the enemy, but we rebuke him as always in the mighty name of Christ, that I've never seen that come up on me. On that screen. But nevertheless, the Lord gave the word, and great was the company of those that published it. Kings of armies did flee apace, and she that tarried at home divided the spoil. And though ye have leaned among the pots, yet shall ye be as the wings of a dove, covered with silver, and her feathers with yellow gold. When the Almighty scattered kings in it, it was white as snow and sodden. So now he's talking about an is among them, as in Sinai in the holy place. I'm going to stop right there because, you know, we have to talk about the fact that he says, excuse me, the chariots of God. And he says, the chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. Okay, so that's just telling you about how when God comes, when he get ready to send forth and do something, how he sends out thousands and thousands of angels. He says, thou hast ascended on high. Thou hast led captivity captive, and thou hast received gifts for men. Yes, for the rebellious also, that the Lord God might dwell among them. So now he's talking about what Christ, what the Heavenly Father did in sending Christ to earth, and him coming to earth when he just ascended, and how he gave gifts to all, and made gifts available to all those, even the rebellious also, he says, so that they could know his presence. So, you know, no one can say they didn't see God's presence. They didn't get an opportunity to view his presence so that they could come into his kingdom and acknowledge him as God, because he's made it so very possible, so very obvious, okay, through the resurrection of Christ and through the coming of Christ. So verse 19 says, blessed be the Lord who daily loads us with benefits, even the God of our salvation. For he that is our God is the God of salvation. And unto God the Lord belongs the issues from death. But God shall wound the head of his enemies, and the hairy scalp of such as one as goes on still in his trespasses. So he says it right here in verse 20, he will, or verse 21, he will wound the head of his enemies. Okay? Those who are against God, those who plot against the saints of God, those who plot against saints of God, their will, their destiny, God's will for their life, their destiny for their life, all of those, God says he's right here, he will wound the head of the individuals that try to accomplish that. And he also will, the hairy scalp of the one that is still in his trespasses, has not confessed his trespasses unto the Heavenly Father. Just confession alone sometimes can deliver you, because you're admitting to God that you're wrong, you know, you've been wrong in what you did, you know, you've been wrong against what, you know, he would have wanted you to do, or how he would may have wanted you to live. Just admitting and confessing, humbling ourselves, humbling, being in a humble position where we actually submit to the authority of God's way and his reign of doing things, okay? So that one that does not do that is still stuck in their trespasses, because once you admit and you submit to God's reverence, his holiness, and his sovereignty, when you submit unto him, you're humbling yourself unto him, and you're confessing right then and there that you're a transgressor, that you're a sinner. So verse 22 says, the Lord said, I will bring again from Bashan, I will bring my people again from the depths of the sea, that thy foot may be dipped in the blood of thine enemies, and the tongue of thy dogs in the sand. For they have seen thy goings, O God, even the goings of my God, my King, in the sanctuary. Okay, so now he's getting ready to talk about the sanctuary. The singers went before, the players on instruments followed after, and among them were the damsels playing with timbrels. Bless ye God in the congregations, even the Lord from the fountain of Israel. For there is little Benjamin with their ruler, the princes of Judah and their council, the princes of Zebulun and the princes of Naphtali. So he's talking about all the children of Israel, and all the, you know, how they're praising God in the sanctuary, or even how they come into the presence of God, just praising him. Because he said, enter into my gates with praise and thanksgiving. And so that means, specifically, before you even you know, begin to, at times, depending upon where you're going in your prayer, I would say, like he says, enter into your, you know, my gates with praise and thanksgiving. There's a praise and a thanksgiving and a worship that we can begin with before we even enter into petitioning God or praying to him. So he says, thy God has commanded thy strength. Strengthen, O God, that which thou hast wrought for us. Because of thy temple at Jerusalem shall kings bring presents to thee. So rebuke the company of spearmen, the multitudes of bulls, with the cows of people, until every one submit himself with pieces of silver. Scatter thy people that delight in war. And princes shall come out of Egypt. Ethiopia shall soon stretch out her hands to God. So, you know, now he's going into just saying different little things about God, circumstances he's seen, you know, just speaking, just put a song together with bits and pieces of a little bit of everything. And this one, because he says, sing unto God, ye kingdoms of the earth. Oh, sing praises unto the Lord, Salah, and to him that rise upon the heavens of heavens, which were of old. Lo, he does send out his voice, and that a mighty voice it is. So ascribe ye strength unto God. His excellency is over Israel, and his strength is in the clouds. And he says, O God, thou art troubled out of thy holy places. The God of Israel is he that gives strength and power to his people. Blessed be God. Oh God, hallelujah, blessed be God, hallelujah. In the mighty name of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. So this psalm, basically, David is, more than anything, he's giving praise, reverence, worship, and honor to God. And taking us back in time and reflecting on some of the things, you know, that God did for his people and how, you know, and why he did those different things and how good he was, you know, to us. And then, you know, because he's saying a little bit of everything in this psalm, because he just switched up and said, verse 31, princes shall come out of Egypt and Ethiopia shall soon stretch out her hands unto God. You know, just again, admiration toward God in many different ways and forms. And it's a pretty exciting song. Again, basically going into praise and worship about our God. And we, you know, because again, he does tell us to enter into his presence with praise and thanksgiving. So definitely we want to say a prayer today. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this Bible study. God bless each and every individual that has an opportunity to hear your word here on this channel or anywhere, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Christ Jesus, we thank you for your word, because it is a light. As you have decreed and declared, it is a light. It guides us throughout the earth. It tells us and gives us what we need to know about ourselves, about you, about who we are to be in the earth, and who you have created us to be in the earth. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, amen, we thank you. God bless all who had an opportunity to hear and to visit the Feed My Sheep Foundation video channel today.